In this video, we are going to discuss concatenation of arrays. That means how to concatenate multiple arrays to a single array. And also we shall discuss on multidimensional arrays. The array which will having multiple dimensions, how to declare them, how to operate on them, we'll be discussing with some sample code and its execution. And from the outcome, we'll be having the idea that how to deal with them. So here is the demonstration for you. In this video, we shall discuss that how to do the concatenation between arrays and how to deal with the multi-dimensional array. So that is the main purpose and main objective of this video. So let us go through some sample codes. Val arr1 is equal to array 10, 20, 30, 40. That means arr1 is one dimensional array which is having four values 10, 20, 30 and 40 and of integer type. Similarly, we have defined this array 2 ARR2 with this set of values. So now let me execute this code, how to define the one dimensional array in our Scala programming. So that array have got defined, that is ARR1 and ARR2. Now we're going to do the concatenation of these two arrays. So concat ARR1, ARR2. So now the thing is that this particular line will show some error message. Just let me show you that it is showing errors and then we shall go for the remedial actions. So now it is telling that not found the value concat. So this function is unknown to that. So for that we are supposed to import this respective package. So now if I execute my code, I think now the two arrays ARR1 and ARR2 will get concatenated. So here you can find that this particular package, required package, has got imported. So var arr3 is equal to concat arr1 comma arr2. This concat, this particular method is actually doing the concatenation between arr1 and arr2 to linear arrays. So when we are printing this arr3, you can find that arr1, the first array content is there, and then the second array content have been placed in one dimensional array arr3. So now we're going to create one array using range. So how to do that one? Just I'm executing the code. Check here. So now here we are defining this arr3 and it will get populated with the value from 2 to 15. As we didn't mention the step, so that's why the step will be 1 here. So 2 comma 15 comma 1 we can write, otherwise we can write 2 comma 15. But if we require to put some step value which is other than 1, in that case obviously after putting comma, after 15, I must be putting the step value, that is the increment value. So in this case you are finding this one where we have got this array got populated with this all data. And remember, it is not reaching up to this 15, but it is 15 minus 1. So that's why 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 up to 11, 12, 13 and 14 you are getting here. And when you are printing this array arr3, we are getting the required output. So now here we are having not the increment factor but the decrement factor, because here the starting number is greater than the finishing number. So what will happen? Not it will not reach to the finishing number 2, but it will reach just prior to that. So 15 comma 2 comma minus 2. So in this way you are getting this output, that is the arr4 you can find. And here we are printing this value of arr4. You can find that the array has got defined, along it the array has got initialized with some specified values using range. Next, where we are going to discuss and deal with the multi-dimensional array. So here arr5 is a multi-dimensional array of dimension integer type 3, 3. That means this array will have 3 rows and 3 columns. It is a square. So now I will be ranging from 0 to 2. So 0, 1, 2, and j will be ranging from 0 to 2, so that is 0, 1, 2. So arr5, 1, I, j will be, we are writing this one as I plus j within curly braces. Look at the syntax, here we have put that one within curly braces. So what will happen? This j, I plus j is nothing but one expression. It will have some value, it will have some r value, and that will be assigned on the left hand side, that is arr5, I, comma j. So now in the first iteration, I will have the value 0. So 0 plus 0, 0 plus 1, 0 plus 2. That means the first row will get filled up with 0, 1, 2. In the next iteration, I will have the value 1. So 1 plus 0, 1 plus 1, 1 plus 2. That means the second row will get filled up with 1, 2 and 3. In this way, in that last iteration, I will have the value 2. So 2 plus 0, 2 plus 1, 2 plus 2. So we are getting this one as 2, 3, 4. So let me execute the code, and you can find that whatever we have explained logically, we are finding the same in the required output. So here you see 0, 1, 2, and then 1, 2, 3, and then 2, 3, 4 are the respective contents for this two-dimensional array named as ARR5. So in this video, we have discussed that how to concatenate two arrays to form the other array, and how to fill up one array while declaring with initializing with the value using the range, and how to deal with the multi-dimensional array. So I think now the array conception is clear to you. Please go on typing your code so that you can gain some confidence. Thanks for watching this.